Upon entering the DQP inspection area, the handler gives the horse's back number and class number for which he's been entered. The first part of the inspection process is thermography, looking for any abnormal heat patterns. The second part of this procedure is referred to as swabbing, otherwise known as gas chromatography, looking for the application of any foreign substances. The pasturing areas will be swabbed in each area, the back, the sides, and the front. Each pasturing area is swabbed independently. The second part of the inspection process, the horse is led in front of the DQP, directed to do a figure eight around two cones. The DQP himself monitors the horse's movement, so the horse maintains free and easy movement at all times. Then the horse is directed to the DQP inspector, and his process begins, always with the left foreleg. The inspector will palpate the tendon area and then move to the rear pastern of the horse's ankle. Then the foreleg is moved forward in front of the horse, and the inspector checks for any sensitive areas on the sides and the front. Then the inspector will move over to the right foreleg and begin the same process again. It's after this inspection by the DQP that the VMO, or the USDA veterinarian, will step in. He'll monitor the horse's movement around this same figure eight pattern. Then the horse is directed back to the VMO for his process of inspection to begin. The final stage of the DQP inspection process, the horse is led over to perform x-rays on each foreleg, again beginning with the left leg and then proceeding to the right to check for any rotation in the coffin bone. upon being cleared in all these different areas of the inspection process, the horse is directed to the warm-up area, and then the process begins to prepare the horse for competition.